You ever had one of those jobs that you've worked at for a while, for a long time, and for whatever reason, you end up having to leave, but you left on good terms, and your manager hits you with that, oh, hey, if you ever need to come back, if you ever need a job again, you're more than welcome to come back home. And a lot of times, some managers will just say that just to say it, but sometimes managers will actually mean it. And it seems as if in this case, Tony Jefferson's former manager, former general manager, Eric DaCosta, meant what he said when he said, hey, if you need to come back home, just let me know. Because the Ravens are working out former 49er, former Arizona Cardinal, but also former Baltimore Raven, Tony Jefferson. And Eric DaCosta did let us know in a press conference before. He said, sometimes we work out guys just to help them out, just to put their name back out there again. And we've seen it happen with guys like Crockett Gilmore, because I remember when Ravens worked him out last year, it was like, whoa, Crockett Gilmore, what? Are they about to bring him back? And then you never heard of anything again. And then there will be some guys that they work out like that go to Michigan because you know Harbaugh's brother coaches there, Jimmy. So they got to put his guys on too. And it's just one of those things that just happens. But in this case, Tony Jefferson is not some up and coming undrafted rookie free agent. He's not some 1-2 year player that's trying to make his name in the league. No, people already know who Tony Jefferson is. He's a well-established veteran in the NFL. So he wouldn't even really need any help. So that's why this workout is so significant. And that I don't think is just to put his name out there for other people, especially the timing. Like we're going into week 15. We're going into week 15. People ain't just doing random workouts for no reason. Like, it's crunch time. Teams are like, all right, this is who we are. And yeah, we could do a little stuff here and there to get better, but this is who we are. Teams have their identities. And the Ravens, they, even though their identity is a crazy one, they have an identity. But anyway, Tony Jefferson, yesterday... Tony Jefferson set this up. He knew what he was doing. Because Tony Jefferson, he said, defense needs turnover right here. Let's go, Ravens. And he edited the Ravens, of course. He knew what he was doing with that one. He knew it. And then my guy, Fear the Bank, on Twitter, his name is Flock Trust. He said, please come back. And then Tony Jefferson responded, about to land. So he set that up so perfect because he wanted somebody to say, he knew somebody was going to say it because people had already been asking. But Tony Jefferson, he threw that little alley-oop. My guy Fear the Bank caught it. Tony, boom, slam dunked it. So Tony Jefferson working out for the Ravens. And this could be a significant reunion. Now, I think Ravens, Jeff Zrebic, he even said it. He said the Ravens could end up signing Tony Jefferson to the practice squad. And, hey, what could it hurt? Tony Jefferson is somebody, I remember when he was here before, he struggled sometimes, but he also made some plays. But one thing that he had that you really can't teach is effort. It's effort. And I think this signing would do a lot for the Ravens when it just comes to heart. Because you can have or not have the players to make the plays. You can have or not have the players to be in position. But when you are lacking heart, when you're lacking that effort, when you're lacking that just nastiness, especially on defense, especially for the Ravens, if you're lacking that, oh, it can be rough. It can be rough. And somebody who the Ravens have been missing is, and maybe it's a West Coast thing, maybe these West Coast boys just bring it like that, especially on defense. But somebody that the Ravens have been missing when it comes to heart on defense all year long. Y'all already know whose name I'm about to say. You can put it in the comment section before you watch this part of the video. But somebody who's they have been missing literally all season long, who continue to bring heart. You talk trash to him, he will walk up in the stands and say, what?
What was that now? You want to repeat it? You want to run that back? Run that by me one more time, please. Marcus Peters, MP Juice Man. He brought so much heart to this Ravens defense. And he just so happened to be a pretty good player, too. And I think when they say when you don't know what you have till it's gone. Oh, no. Ravens and Ravens fans, we knew what we had with Marcus Peters. Oh, we knew what we had with Marcus Peters. But I think him being gone this season, especially the way that it happened, because it was so sad the way that it happened, the sequence of events. Because I remember with Marcus Peters, sorry, Pookie just walking around. Pookie, move. Stop. But anyway, with Marcus Peters, I don't need her biting on Ravens flakes. But with Marcus Peters, I remember there was a presser where this guy was just speaking from his heart. And it was just, this was the best Ravens presser I had ever watched at being a Ravens fan, ever. It was the best one. I'm sure Ray Lewis got some really good ones too. But, well, recently then, it was the best Ravens presser ever. And it was really the most touching Ravens presser. Because that one hit me. It hit me big time. My eyes start getting a little teary and all that too. Because when Marcus Peters was speaking, man, this guy just, and it wasn't just about football. He was talking about his family. He was talking about the kids. He was just talking about just making it out. He was just talking about so much different stuff. And it was just such a strong press conference. And I remember when we did a video talking about it, I'm like, man, this dude, like, I love that he is a Raven. Love it. Love it. And it just made you an even bigger Marcus Peters fan. And then it wasn't even a week later, that's when the report came out, Marcus Peters out for the year. And it was like, wow. Wow. So Ravens have been missing that attitude on defense. They've been missing it. So Tony Jefferson, he could possibly bring that back. Now we know it, Wink. It's all about the more you can do. I remember Tony Jefferson. There were a lot of people that got on Tony Jefferson when he struggled with the Ravens on defense, when he may have found himself out of place with the Ravens on defense. But I remember he responded to some comments on Twitter, obviously a long time ago, and he said that, hey, I'm learning a brand new way to play the safety position. I'm learning like two different roles when it comes to playing a safety position. And if the Ravens do end up signing him, I'm hoping. Oh boy, I'm hoping they use him for what he specialized in Arizona. He was a box safe, but again, you got Chuck Clark though. You got Chuck Clark. That's his role. Like with Chuck Clark, we always make fun of it. I always say Chuck Clark is outside linebacker. But because Chuck Clark, his job, it seems as if is to be around the box, to set the edge, and to blitz. So Chuck Clark, he ain't nothing but a linebacker. But with Tony Jefferson, that's the same type of role that's where he thrived in Arizona. That's why he did so well there. So when Ravens signed Tony Jefferson, it's like, oh, okay, that's what we're getting. That's what we about to use him as. But they didn't. They didn't. And there's nothing wrong with expanding your resume and expanding your what you can do. But Ravens, like, when they did put him around the box, he thrived. But when they dropped him back, there were struggles from time to time. But I hope that Ravens, they can put him in positions to succeed. I hope they can play him to his strengths. And I just really hope, if they sign him, of course. I mean, I would think that they will. Because I don't think they, like, with Ravens, sort of that, oh, they want that old thing back. With Ravens, when they go for that old thing, they usually make it happen. You see Pernell McPhee. You see Brandon Stokely. Like, when they do that, when they come back around to you, they don't just work you out for nothing.
So I would definitely anticipate the Ravens signing Tony Jefferson between today and tomorrow. I would say tomorrow at the latest, since practice is on Wednesday. That's what I would expect. I don't think this workout is just, let's just put your name out there. No, I think this is for a reason. If Ravens do sign him, I just, like I said, hope they use him the right way. And what Tony Jefferson also brings is just experience. He brings experience. He was obviously part of some really good Ravens teams. And maybe Ravens just, they just need a tap on the shoulder from somebody with some experience. Like, hey, this is how we win. This is what we need to do. And maybe you just need some more veteran leadership too. You can never have enough of that. And that's something that I learned the hard way when John Harbaugh kicked Ed Reed. Ooh, Harbaugh kicked Ed Reed out. He said, "You gotta go. You're out of here, buddy." Ed Reed, Ed Reed wanted to stay. And we have still not found a safety to replace Ed Reed. And again, that's Ed Reed. It's not fair. It's Ed Reed. Like, he was Ed Reed. But again, we found linebackers that have replaced Ray Lewis. But, well, C.J. Mosley did. And Daryl Smith, he was a nice little Band-Aid. But C.J. Mosley was doing his thing. But we have not come close to finding a safety to replace Ed Reed. But anyway, after Harbaugh kicked Ed Reed out and then Ray Lewis retired, that really helped me appreciate leadership more than I had, because I had not appreciated it as much as I did after when that happened. Because in 2013, I was like, whoa, 8-8? Who's going to lead this team? What's going on? And yeah, so it was what it was. And then 2014, who did they get? Steve Smith Sr. Boom. No, wow. We're winners again. So it was obviously a mix of adding a playmaker too, but leadership as well, man. Leadership. So anyway, Team Keep It Clean, appreciate y'all. We'll see what comes of this workout. And if the Ravens end up making it official by signing Tony Jefferson over the next 24, 36 hours. Love y'all. Appreciate y'all. We out.